The college football playoff is always a hot topic and hot debate, makes for good radio and TV and all those kinds of things. And that's why it's fun tonight, because there's a lot of people that are mad and a lot of people that want to tell you that they're mad about it. And I say mad because you look at Oklahoma. Abigail is mad, I can tell you, because Oklahoma's not in the top five. Remember, they're fourth in the AP poll. But here you go. You look at the first rankings of the college football playoff out tonight. And instead, look, OU's undefeated. Alabama has a loss, number two. Oregon has a loss, number four. Ohio State has a loss, number five. Meanwhile, they're down in the second five. Oklahoma is eighth. Remember, they're 9-0, but they're eighth in this. OU, by the way, has the longest winning streak in the country. They've won 17 games in a row, and they're eighth. So if you want to be mad, that's fine. Oklahoma State, by the way, is 11th. And so they're really in good position if they run the table and all those things sort themselves out. But Lincoln Riley was asked earlier today about the rankings and what they might mean and what they might tell us. He said this earlier before the rankings, but here's what he said. Not much.
Yeah, it's just, to me, it's just meaningless stuff to kill the time until we get to the end. I mean, it's the biggest games, the best games, the most important games all across the country have still yet to be played. And so there's, a lot of good teams that are vying for it, and the best ones tend to rise up this time of year and separate themselves, and that'll happen again this year.
You know, one of the things that might separate the Sooners down the road from everybody else is this kid right here. Boy, Caleb Williams turned into one of the biggest stories in all of college football, and I guess when you throw six touchdown passes in a game, people notice that kind of thing. They certainly have. He was the Davey O'Brien National Quarterback of the Week this week after his afternoon against the Red Raiders. And think about this. He's been the starting quarterback for three games at Oklahoma, really played in just 3.5 games. He is number two in the Big 12 with 14 touchdown passes. He's done it in 3.5 games. Been electric. Turned into one of the best quarterbacks in the country. By the way, OU's off this week. Have Baylor in a week. I do want to stay with Lincoln Riley tonight. And I want to talk about Gary Patterson, right? He was fired at TCU after 20 years as their head coach, fired in the middle of the season. And a lot of people noticed he was fired in the middle of the season. One of those people that's mad about it and didn't like it was Lincoln Riley.
You know, I don't know all the circumstances behind it, but seeing Gary Patterson go out in the middle of a season is just... I don't know what to think of it, man. I was sick when I heard the news, to be completely honest. I know it's a tough business, and I know, you know, we gotta, you know, our jobs are scrutinized, and you know, we're big boys and can live with big boy decisions. But man, I mean, yeah, you got Gary Patterson not finishing a season at place he built, man. That ain't right.